If my math is correct, our entire cost for today only $10.
Only $10, baby, for whole day.
Welcome back to Follow the Imprints with Sudeshna and Ranjit, and today is a brand new day in Kuala Lumpur where we are going to explore the famous Batu Caves.
Yeah. So there are two options to go to Batu Caves. Number one, take a Grab, go directly.
That's the fastest.
But we always prefer the local transit. So we'll take the MRT from Chausso Lin MRT, and from there we'll go to another station. From there, that station we'll take the train that is directly to Batu Caves. So let's go, buy the ticket.
LRT, we will go to Bandaraya. Two. Cash.
320.
So,
we got our ticket. Now we are going to Bandaraya. From Bandaraya, we'll take the train to Batu Caves.
It cost us 380 for two for the first hour.
So from Bandaraya line, we have to cross the road to take the Seremban line, which will take us to Batu Caves. Not sure how to go the other side. Maybe this way. Oh, that bridge. Okay.
Batu Caves. Return.
Two adult.
920. These are the
card not detected.
So the machine failed us. We then went to the counter with a K and bought our return ticket. 920. Let's go. I think no one takes the public transit here to Batu Caves.
Yeah, we are the only 2% literally in this entire platform for Batu.
Maybe they will take from another station or something. Maybe Putra.
So. Yeah.
Putra is a big station. That is the next station. Maybe they will take from there. But yeah, this is really empty.
Mostly because from the city to Batu Caves, you can just take a Grab and it's half an hour. So it's very easier. Already been like more than an hour, and we reached here. So it will take another how many minutes?
Maybe 40 minutes around.
Yeah. So it's like a 1.5 hour journey from the city when you take the public transit.
We have all the time in the world.
We have time.
So our whole journey to Batu Caves to our hotel, go and return, it's 17 ringgit. Whereas just one way from our hotel to Batu Caves in Grab, it was showing 50 ringgit. So it was total around 100 ringgit for cab for two, and for this one the public transit only 17. So cheap. One thing to remember, the frequency of this train, it's very low. Now it is 10:30, the next train is 11:08. We have to wait here almost 40 minutes. So we are still waiting for our train.
This video will be like the journey to Batu Caves and not Batu Caves.
Yeah, journey is important, not the destination. So let's do the journey. And in the station they have QR code. You can scan this QR code and get your train schedule. Ours is showing on time. Let's see. Hope for the best.
11 more minutes to go.
The train came right on time.
Left, right, and it's 11:08.
Yeah. This is good.
And it's during AC.
And the seats are actually very nice. It's two seaters. This is very good. Not sure what, but something is wrong with the train or line.
Something they told about security issue, so it will be delayed. It's waiting here since the last 5 minutes. We'll reach Batu Caves.
Definitely. Again, journey is important, not the destination, baby. First spotting of the monkey before the Batu Caves in the station. So finally at 11:35 we have reached Batu Caves station. Now we are hungry. Maybe we'll have our lunch first, then go to caves.
So we ordered two egg dosa. We'll just fill our appetite a bit and then we will lose it when climbing up.
because it's almost 12 and it's our lunch time, we can't work without food inside our belly.
And there are monkeys everywhere.
Everywhere. So we ordered egg dosa. Let's see. Perfect. This is one of the best ones.
Thank you.
Thank you. So now we are all fed. Now we are going to the Batu Caves. Batu, that means rock in Malay. Technically translation?
Rock
cave.
It's a limestone cave, yeah, which has been formed more than 400 million years ago. So I'll let you know more once we go inside. Finally, we are here at Batu Caves with millions of people and millions of Fijians and hundreds of monkeys. So, be careful with your camera, phone, purses, and don't carry any food items because the monkeys can smell. Let me give you a quick history about the Batu Caves. So this Batu Caves is actually limestone formations which has been formed more than 400 million years ago. There are numerous stalactites and stalagmites rock formations inside it. And there is 272 steps right now to climb on top of the mountains. And inside there are a few Hindu temples which has a ticket entry if you want to go inside the temples. Otherwise, the entry is free for the caves. Gradually, in the 1800s, the Chinese came and started excavating these limestone caves to get some fertilizers for their farm. Then around the 1870s, one American naturalist found this cave and showed it to the entire world and made it famous. Then after that, one Indian Tamil trader, he actually got inspired and established this Hindu god Murugan, which is their main god, and started worshipping him. And since then, this has developed as a Hindu temple, and millions of tourists from all across the world flock to Malaysia and become as one of the iconic signature of Malaysia's tourism. This huge 140 feet golden statue of Lord Murugan took 3 years to build and was constructed very recently in 2006. And this is currently the third tallest Hindu statue in all over the world and the tallest statue in Malaysia. So you need to cover your knees before going into the Hindu temple. So either you wear long pants or carry something like this so that you can wrap it up.
Now our 1000 stairs climb started.
272 to be exact. The rainbow stairs.
Yeah. We came all the way here.
141
heart rate, and we are almost there. There is one dark cave for dark people, but right now it is closed. After 1000 stairs later, we are going inside. Truthfully saying, this cave doesn't look that
It's a more of a religious site than a natural wonder right now. So if you're a believer, you definitely should come here, get some sweat, do the cardio, and there are multiple shops here for you to get your offerings. Inside it's a bit cooler obviously because of the limestone. So now I think we'll be heading down the 272 stairs along with 400 people.
And 500 monkeys.
So there are 2-3 caves in size. Out of that, under the huge ones, they have constructed some temples. So you can go inside the temples, but no shoes allowed.
So up here, you'll get souvenir shop, offering shop, and cold drinks and water shop. So you don't have to worry about anything. You'll get everything in the caves.
It would be a better idea to come in the early morning because this opens at 6 a.m. Don't come in noon like us.
Yeah.
Otherwise, this will be the situation.
Yes. So it's hot. It's 34 degrees. Wow. On top of this mountain?
Yeah, you will get a like panoramic view of the Kuala Lumpur city.
Yeah, it's a very nice view actually.
Yeah. So for that, you should climb.
And also you get the cardio as well, right? Normally we don't do any cardios.
Yeah, normally we eat and sleep and relax.
Yeah, so
it's a good travel. Yeah. After 10 liters of sweating, we have finally made it our way to the down. So now we'll go to the train station and our way back to the city. Came back to our hotel around 2 o'clock, got some rest, freshen up, and now it's time for dinner. Yeah. It's almost 7:30, so we are going out for dinner. We are going to a local Tamil restaurant because entire Malaysia is Tamil influenced, so that is one cuisine we are having here. We'll show you what we eat there. So if you're looking for an observation deck to have an aerial view of the Kuala Lumpur city, then you have actually not two but three options. Other than the Petronas Twin Towers, which we have covered in the previous episode, you also have the option of the KL Tower, which is kind of similar to the Toronto CN Tower, and they have an observation deck with 360 degree views, and the price is $22 per adult. Behind me, I'm not sure whether you can see or not, we have the Marteka 118 Tower, which is the latest addition in the Kuala Lumpur skyline. That is the second highest tallest tower in the entire world after Burj Khalifa, and the tallest tower in entire Southeast Asia. So this has an observation deck above 111th floor, but the observation deck is currently not opened yet for the public. If you are coming after it has opened for the public, please let us know in the comments about your experience.
So we have water refill section in the visit channel.
So we are coming in this restaurant from first night when we
because
came to Kuala Lumpur.
Okay.
Yeah, it's right down all of that. And the restaurant has a good combination of roti, paratha and dosa. The rice is not good, in the lunch section is not good. But in the dinner section, you can have the bread thing. That's good. Let's see what we will have today.
I ordered one roti, which is like a Mughlai parota. If you are Bengali, you will get that. So it's basically like crepe, but a spicy one. Inside you have like eggs, onion, and different kind, whatever you choose. So I chose the egg and onion one, and he chose the egg, onion, and sardine fish. So that's a local delicacy, mixed like with Tamil and Malay. So we will have this for the first time here. And with that, a tea, masala chai.
Indian dish, chai tea.
Ish.
It's not chai tea, it's only tea. There's nothing called chai tea. Chai tea is tea tea. So, this is only tea.
Chai is tea! You're saying tea tea, you dumb dumb!
Sony. Yeah, Sony.
Good. So, I asked for spices. They have given green chilies inside it, so that's giving the actual spice. And it's egg, onion, crepe things, everything, and with that, so whatever gravy they have on that particular day, generally they provide that with the dosas and every roti kind of thing. So I think this is some chicken curry gravy, and this is dal or lentil.
So the dinner came to 3 roti, Mughlai roti, 1 tea, and total cost 18 ringgit.
So whatever, whenever, whichever food we have ate here in this particular restaurant, the bill has always been 18 ringgit.
Yeah, I know.
So we don't know that what's wrong. But anyways, it's very cheap. 18 ringgit is like what? $4?
Yes, around $4. Yes.
Like that. So for two,
very,
it's very cheap. And also, if my math is correct, our entire cost for today, like going to the Batu Caves and coming back for two, having the lunch there, now the dinner, it's actually only $10.
Only $10, baby, for whole day.
Because the trip and the lunch cost us only $6, and now it's like $4, so it's around $10. So Malaysia is cheap. So for our morning breakfast, a carton of milk and chocolate. Thank you so much everyone for watching this video till this end, and this is the end of our Malaysian series. It's a short one, 2 episode 1. Tomorrow we'll be relaxing and is our laundry day. So if you're liking our around the world trip and this Malaysian episodes, and if you have any questions, let us know in the comments, subscribe and share this one with your friends and family.
And please press the like button and the bell icon to get notification of our next country as well. Till then,
for the Emirates. Tres.